Students, in this lecture we'll start with a new topic, which is moment distribution method. Okay, so the moment distribution method is a displacement based method which is introduced by Professor Hardy Cross, and it's a general method which can be used for both beams as well as frame saving sway or without sway. Okay, so this is actually derived from the slope diffusion method, and it is an iterative method of doing the problem. Okay, so what happens here is, in each of the iteration, the slope diffusion equations are solved and you get a value of final moment which is converging towards a precise final result, which is nothing but the end moments. Okay, so before learning what is actually the moment distribution method, we have to know some of the terms which leads to it. Okay, so first one is stiffness. So stiffness may be defined as the amount of actions required for inducing some particular displacement. So it can be stated as force required to induce unit displacement, or it can also be stated as moment required to induce unit rotation. Okay, so stiffness is nothing but P by delta, force by displacement, or it is again moment by rotation, M by theta. So in that case, the stiffness is rotational stiffness. Now let's see two more topics, which is carry over factor and distribution factor. Okay, so now let's consider a beam hinged at both ends. So we have a beam AB which is hinged at A and hinged at B. So at A you apply a moment M, which means that moment at A is equal to M, which means let's write MAB is equal to M. Okay, so this will induce a rotation at theta, rotation theta at A plus theta AB, as well as it introduces a rotation at B which is theta BA. Okay, it is evident from the deflected shape, right? So now let's go back to your slope diffusion equation for MAB and substitute the value of theta AB. Okay, so you get slope diffusion equation something like this. Okay, also it is to be noted that when moment was applied at A, there is no moment applied at B, which means that MBA is equal to zero. Okay, so MBA is nothing but zero, and as per slope diffusion equation, it is nothing but 2a by l into 2 theta by a, 2 theta by a plus theta ab minus 3 delta by l. So delta is zero here. Substituting theta b and theta ab, we get a relationship between theta b and theta ab. So theta b is equal to minus theta ab by 2. Okay, so if you substitute this back in this equation, you get mab is equal to 3a by l into theta ab. So m by theta ab is equal to 3a by l, which is nothing but, this is nothing but stiffness. Okay, so when the far end is hinged, the stiffness at near end is 3a by l. Okay, now let's consider another beam in which the far end is fixed and the near end is pinned, and you apply a unit moment at near end. So MAB is equal to M, and it is to be noted that as per the deflector shape, you can see that there is a value of theta AB, however theta BA is going to be zero because it is B is a fixed end. Okay, so we know MAB is equal to M. Okay, and substituting theta BA is equal to zero, you get MAB is equal to 4a by l into theta b, which means that m by theta b is equal to 4a by l, which means that the stiffness of the beam at the near end is equal to 4a by l when the far end is fixed against the rotation. Okay, also you can see that if you substitute this theta ab value, which is nothing but ml by 4a, okay, in the slope diffusion equation for MBA, you can see that MBA is equal to half of MAB. Okay, so the foreign moment is nothing but half of the near end moment. So it is to be noted that when the far end is fixed, the half of the moment applied at the near end is carried over to the far end. So this phenomenon is called as carry over, and the carry over factor is always half when the far end is fixed. Okay, so carry over moment means nothing but if a moment is applied at the near end, the half of the moment will be carried over to the far end, which is fixed, and this direction of the carry over moment will be in the same direction as at the applied moment. However, if the far end is pinned, there is no carry over moment. Now let's see what happens when several members meet at a particular joint. So let's see that, consider that there is a common point O where several members meet, say four members meet at this particular point. The member 1 and member 3 is having far end hinged, and member 2 and member 4 is having far end fixed, which means that for this end, member 1 and member 3, the stiffness value k1 and k3 is going to be 3a by l, e, I, and l of respective moment members, and for member 2 and 4, the far end is fixed, as you can see, which means that the stiffness of 2 and 4 is going to be 4a by l. So k2 and k4 is 4a by l. Okay, so you can see here for k2 it is 4a by l, for k4 is also 4a by l. So when an unbound moment is applied at this particular joint O, the moment will be distributed among each of the members in the same ratio as of their stiffness. Okay, so this particular distribution proportion is called as distribution factor. Okay, so the distribution factor is nothing but the stiffness of a particular member divided by sum of stiffness of all the members meeting at that particular joint. Okay, so it is important to know that distribution factor for a fixed end is 0, and distribution factor for a simple end is taken always as 1. So I have also given some step by step process for how to solve the moment distribution method. So we can go through this. However, it will be more once we apply and do a problem actually. Okay, so which we can do in detail in the coming classes. Let's see an illustrative example. So we have a two span beam, each of 5 meters, and the span AB is having an eccentric loading, which means that in order to find the fixed end moment, we have to use PAB square by L square, PAB square by PA square B by L square. Okay, for span PC, the loading is symmetric, which means that you can use PL by 8. So you got value of fixed end moments. Okay, now next step is you have to find out the distribution factor. So you know that the member A and member, sorry, joint A and joint C was fixed end, which means that DAB and DCA is going to be 0. At member B, there are two members meeting, BA and BC. Each of them are having equal length, equal EI, and also for both of them the far end is fixed, which means that the stiffness for both of the members is going to be 4a by l, which is 4a by 5. So the distribution factor is going to be 4a by 5 divided by sum of all the stiffness value. So 4a by 5 plus 4 dba plus this 4a by 5 for member BC, right? So you get distribution factor DBA is equal to 0.5. Similarly, you can find the distribution factor for member BC also, which is DBC is equal to 0.5. okay, so once you get this, the first thing you have to do is you have to make a distribution factor member moment distribution table. So what you have to do is you have to write down all the joints at the top in the same order as in the question, and you have to have two ends for each of the members. So there are, this is a column for end A, and this is a column for end B. So this is a column for end B in the span BC, and this is the column for end C in the span BC. Okay. Next step, what you have to do is you have to write down the distribution factor obtained. So DAB was 0, which because it was fixed length. DCB was also 0 because it is again a fixed length. DBA and DBC we have found out, which is nothing but 0.5, 0.5. Once you get this, next step is you have to write down all the fixed end moments. So the fixed end moments has to be write down in the same sign convention as we used in the Stoke reflection equation. So reactive and equivocus moments are negative. So you can see that fixed moments are reactive moments, and here this 2.4 and 5 are anti-clockwise, which means that these are negative. So minus 2.4 and minus 5. Okay, that is written in the respective spaces. And 3.6, which is MVA, and 5, which is CB, are written as positive in the corresponding locations. Okay, now you can see that at A there is an unbalanced moment of minus 2.4. So in order to balance that, you have to apply a positive 2.4. So positive 2.4 multiplied by 0, which is the distribution factor. This becomes 0 actually here. Also here also the value will be 0. Okay. Now if you consider this joint P, there are two moment values. One is plus 3.6 and another one is minus 5. If you sum this, we have a minus 1.4. So in order to balance this, we have to apply a positive 1.4. okay, and this positive 1.4 has to be distributed among both the members B and BC by the multiplying positive 1.4 with respective distribution factor. So 1.4 multiplied by 0.5, you have 0.7 and 0.7. okay, so once the distribution stage is over, next step is you have to do the carryover. So we have to do carryover to whenever the far end is fixed. So you can see that for this member BA, the for joint B, the far end A is fixed. So you can see that half of the plus 0.7 has to be carried over to A. Similarly, for member BC, the far end C is fixed, which means that half of 0.7 has to be carried over to C, which means that 0.7 by 2, which is 0.35, will be carried over to this point. Okay, so at this point there is an unbalanced moment of 0.35 at C, and in order to balance this, we have to give and minus 0.35 at this point multiplied by distribution factor, which is 0. Similar thing will happen here. Okay, so now you can see that there is no more iteration possible. So what is to be done next is you have to sum the values entered in each of the column. Okay, so minus 2.4 plus 0.35, you get minus 2.05, plus 3.6 plus 0.7, you get plus 4.3, minus 5 plus 0.7, you get minus 4.3, plus 5 plus 0.35, you get plus 5.35. So all these values are nothing but your final reactive moments at the respective locations. So once you get this values, you can mark them in your beam, and you can also find out the bending moment diagram. So it will finally look something like this, and all the react moments are marked here. Okay, more examples we will see in the coming courses.